Christelle from Diabetes Strong. In this video, we'll be talking about the Eversense 180-day CGM, which they've named Eversense E3. The 180-day sensor recently got FDA approved and is now commercially available in the US. So I thought it'd be fun to do a deep dive on it. I'll go over what makes Eversense unique, what are some of the pros and the cons of the Eversense, and then finally, we're gonna talk a little bit about the cost of the Eversense product. And also, just because I know you'll ask, and because I've got this question quite a bit frequently, will I or will I not try the Eversense E3? Since I haven't any experience with the product myself, I've asked a friend from the diabetes community, come join me in this video and share his experience. So let's just start out by having Paul introduce himself.
Hey guys, it's Paul from Type 1 Outdoors. Type 1 Outdoors is my website where I encourage Type 1s to get outdoors with confidence. Now, many of my followers already know that I've been using the Eversense CGM for just about 3 years now. Now, other CGMs that I have used, I've used the Dexcom systems and I've also used the Medtronic systems. And of course, I started with the systems that would only last like 3 to 5 days, then the 10 days, then the 14 days, and then of course, Eversense, which was started off with the 90-day system, and now I'm on the 6-month 180-day sensor. I was so excited to get onto the E3 system because of the 6-month sensor. How awesome is that? One sensor, 6 whole months. Oh my God, we've been waiting forever for this.
And I know this is a longer video, we do have a lot of stuff to cover, but if you're only interested in parts of the video, just go down to the video description. I have added time codes to the different sections of the video. So if you're only interested in, let's say, the cost of the system, go down there, find the cost, click on that time code, and you'll be taken directly to that part of the video. Now let's dig in. A few things makes the Eversense unique. One being that it's the first and only available implantable continuous glucose monitor, or CGM. It has been available in the US for a while. The 90-day sensor has been available since 2018. Actually, if you're in Europe, you've had access to the 180-day sensor since 2017. And now finally here in 2022, we now in the US also have access to the 180-day Eversense sensor. And that one they've named the Eversense E3. Eversense E3, it's the latest CGM to get FDA approval here in the US. And as of April 4th, 2022, it's been commercially available in the US for patients 18 years and older. The system consists of a small sensor that's inserted underneath the skin by a healthcare professional, and then you wear a rechargeable transmitter on top of that on your skin. So the sensor has to be inserted and removed by a healthcare professional. It's not something that you can do yourself. I've seen a demo of the insertion at a conference, and it's fairly straightforward. So the healthcare professional will numb the skin, and then insert the sensor right underneath the skin. And once the wound is healed, you can't see the sensor, but if you feel, if you know where to apply pressure, you'll be able to feel it underneath the skin.
It's completely painless, and it takes probably about maybe 3 to 5 days to heal the incision. And it's a tiny, tiny, tiny little incision. And that's what most people are unaware of, because like it is a surgically implanted sensor. That's why it lasts up to 6 months. You do have to go visit a nurse practitioner, dermatologist, endocrinologist, those who have been trained in inserting the Eversense sensor will be able to insert that in about 10 minutes maybe. My doctor is really quick at it now. He can have a new sensor in about 3 minutes. He's actually doing really, really good. I think we've broken some records.
We're done.
Voila.
Voila!
And of course, as a patient, I don't get to see any of this.
All right. Ta-da!
The implantable sensor is fluorescent-based, and the transmitter that you wear on top will send blood sugar readings to an app on your phone every 5 minutes. It also has the option of giving on-body vibrations, so alerting you on-body. That means that the actual transmitter that you'll wear on your arm will vibrate whenever you're about to go high or low. So that's a little different from the other CGMs available. Those you only have the vibration on your phone or on your watch. Again, this one actually will vibrate directly on your skin. As I mentioned before, I had the chance to see a demo of Eversense at a conference a few years back. And I actually also got to try the transmitter on. I didn't try the sensor, just the transmitter. And this is a photo of that. So what you see here is me wearing the transmitter and the Eversense transmitter. And what you see next to it is the Dexcom T5, because that was the CGM I wore back then. And you can kind of get a feel for the size here. Now let's talk about the pros and the cons of the Eversense E3. I'm trying to keep this video from becoming way too long, so I have narrowed it down to my top 4 pros and my top 4 cons. I think the biggest upside to the Eversense E3 is that you only have to change your sensor every 180 days. So assuming that the sensor doesn't fail or anything like that, that means that you only have to think about supplies and insertion twice a year. That's a big deal. The only thing you have to do on a daily basis is that you have to charge your transmitter and you have to change the transmitter tape occasionally. But just for comparison, the Freestyle Libre is a 2-week wear, so 14 days. Dexcom T6 is a 10-day wear. This is a completely different ballpark. The second upside is the transmitter. This is the only CGM system that allows you to take off the transmitter whenever you want to. So that also means that it does get bumped off. Don't worry about it. You just put it back on. You don't lose the sensor. So that also means that, for example, let's say that you want to take a shower without being attached to anything. You can do that with the system. Just take it off. Or maybe you're having a little bit of alarm fatigue, or you just don't feel like wearing it, doesn't go with the outfit, whatever. You decide. You can take it on and off whenever you want to. So the only thing is that when you do take it off, you will not be getting any blood sugar readings. So there's that.
Now the transmitter still is about the same size. The transmitter does come off. The transmitter is waterproof. The transmitter needs to be recharged every day or every 2 days. That's another cool thing about the adhesive, is that it uses silicone adhesive, so it's hypoallergenic. It doesn't bother the skin like other adhesives do. And, you know, no skin irritation. It's just silicone, so, you know, no weird chemicals. The transmitter does need to be recharged, and it recharges in about 10 minutes. And I usually recharge it at night if I'm taking a shower, or you can let it go for a couple days until the battery runs out. If I'm out and about in the wilderness, I'll probably use my solar charger to give it a solar recharge. Again, 10 minutes, no big deal. And currently I'm on MDI. Since I'm not using a pump and I'm not using a adhered CGM, this transmitter can be removed whenever I want. I get to take a naked shower every single day. How cool is that? Got a double stick silicone sticky that sticks from the back of the sticks to the back of the transmitter. And then this sticky can then stick onto my skin right on top of where the sensor is.
The third upside is the accuracy. Eversense E3 is highly accurate. It's actually the most accurate CGM available in the US right now. Accuracy when it comes to a CGM is measured in something called MARD, M-A-R-D. Stands for mean absolute relative difference. And the E3 has a MARD of 8.5%. For comparison, the Dexcom G6 MARD is 9%. The Freestyle Libre 2 MARD is 9.3%, and the Medtronic Guardian 3 MARD is 8.7%. And as you probably figured by now, the lower the MARD, the more accurate the device.
The accuracy is unmatched. It is good.
The final pro that I want to highlight is initial price, because that's really good if you have Medicare or you have commercial insurance that does cover the Eversense products. So if you do, you can utilize their PASS program. With their PASS program, you can get your first 6-month sensor for $99. And after that, you can get each sensor for $600. So that means an ongoing cost of $100 a month. That, however, does not cover the doctor visit where you get the insertion and the removal of the sensor. You'll have to pay for that as well. Now let's talk about some of the downsides of this product. So the first con that I come to mind for me is that you do need a small insertion made in your arm every 6 months. And it's my understanding that some people are also having a hard time finding a doctor near them who can do the insertion. I saw this insertion done on a dummy at a conference, and it really didn't seem like a big deal. I mean, if you're used to the other CGMs available on the market, like the Libre, the Dexcom, or the Medtronic, it might seem like a slightly bigger deal than what you're doing today. The medical professional who inserts a sensor does have to be trained to do so. So you can't just go to any medical professional. If you go to Eversense website, they do have a form that you can fill out and they can help you find a healthcare professional in your area. But how about we ask Paul? Paul, what was your experience?
I didn't have to do any of the legwork. In fact, Eversense or Ascensia, who is the marketing company for Eversense, they have a whole list of doctors who are trained to insert the Eversense sensor. So typically you just contact Ascensia and they will find out where you live and suggest a number of either dermatologists, nurse practitioners, endocrinologists who are trained to insert the Eversense. And they will send you a list of your local doctors who have been trained in inserting the Eversense sensor.
The other downside that comes to mind for me is that you need a doctor if your sensor fails or if you get an infection. That does mean that you have to do some level of planning. So what happens if your sensor expires while you're on vacation or while you're away, or if you just can't get a doctor's appointment when you need to have your sensor changed? I know for me that would require some level of, again, planning, just because I do plan on being out of the US a lot of the year, these coming years, traveling a lot. So again, everything can be done, of course, you just have to plan it. And then there's a warm-up period and the amount of calibrations. So that's definitely something we need to talk about. Not only is there a 24-hour warm-up period where you won't get any readings, blood sugar readings, but this system also needs to be calibrated on a daily basis. So that means every day you have to do a manual finger stick and calibrate your system. You have to do 4 calibrations within the first 36 hours. Then you have to do 2 calibrations daily for the first 21 days of the sensor. And after that, you have to do 1 to 2 calibrations daily for the rest of the sensor lifetime. The last downside that I want to highlight is the lack of integration with other systems. So this CGM does not integrate with any pumps or any smart pens. But, you know, neither does the FreeStyle Libre, so that might not be that big of an issue for a lot of people. Those were my top pros and cons of the Eversense E3. But I also asked Paul, so let's see what he had to say.
Pros and cons. Some things I love about it, some things I don't quite love about it, but in general, I really love it. And what I really love about it is the extended sensor life. Now, I know it lasts 6 months with just one sensor, but did you also know that I don't need to see my readings on my phone to know what my blood sugar is doing? I don't have to get these annoying sounds on my phone, although it's an option, I can. But what I do like is that the transmitter actually vibrates to let me know what the blood sugar is doing, which means that I don't have to have a phone or a watch nearby to know what my blood sugar is doing. My blood sugar could be trending up, trending down, and I'll know about it because of the vibration pattern that the transmitter sends right here on my arm. How cool is that? There's also some other smart enhancements made to the system on the E3. So new, upgraded, smart technology to know whether or not the sensor is behaving correctly, whether the readings are a little wonky, it'll correct itself. So kudos to that for making this a truly smart system. One thing that I don't like is I still need to calibrate. Initially, when you first get the sensor in, you have to calibrate 2 times a day. But after 21 days, the system is smart enough to know that accuracy is dialed in and I can just back off to 1 calibration a day. That's kind of nice because Eversense prides themselves on accuracy and it's really accurate. I mean, within 1 or 2 points in when I do a calibration, very accurate.
Now let's go back to that last pro that I mentioned, the initial price. And remember, that's actually only a pro if you have insurance that covers Eversense. But just to recap the costs, if you have Medicare or if you have commercial insurance that does cover Eversense on the plan, the initial sensor is $99 if you use what they have named the PASS program, P-A-S-S, PASS program. Then after that, it'll be $600 per sensor, so that's $600 every 6 months. That's an average cost of $100 a month. On top of that, you also have to pay for the insertion and removal of the sensor. And that will depend on how much your doctor charges. According to Healthline, healthcare professionals generally will charge you $200 to $300 to insert a sensor and $300 to $400 to remove it. But I think that highly depends on your insurance and if you have insurance at all. So I think the key is still to reach out to your doctor, whoever's going to do the insertion, and simply ask. But when it comes to cost, I think you also have to think about, can you find a healthcare professional close to you? Do you need to travel in order to get the sensor inserted and removed? And if so, you have to add that cost on top of things. If you do not have insurance or do not have an insurance that's willing to pay for Eversense, I found the following prices on Healthline. Please remember, this is based on a 90-day sensor. Their official pricing for the 180-day sensor is not really available yet. The price that Healthline has calculated is roughly $2,400 to $2,800 a year for the product itself, and then $500 to $700 for doctor's visits. That means that the total cost a year comes to $2,900 up to $3,500. So that means a monthly cost of $242 to $292. And just for a little bit of comparison here, with insurance, I pay about $87 a month for my Dexcom G6 system. So that's both transmitters and sensors. And if I were to pay cash for it, I would be paying around $343 a month. So am I ready to try the Eversense E3 CGM? Probably not. Here's why. The main thing that bothers me about this system is the need for daily calibrations. I don't want to have to do daily finger sticks. Also, I'm not super keen on having a small, it might be small, but a small insertion in my upper arm done every 6 months. I scar super easily, and call me vain, that's okay, you're allowed to do that, but it does contribute to my decision. My travel plans for the next 3 years also makes this a little bit more complicated. So given I don't plan on being in the US a whole lot, having to commit to a 6 month schedule where I have to be in the US, I get the sensor removed and a new one inserted, it makes things a little bit more complicated. And finally, I really like my current Dexcom InPen and Fitbit integration. I really like that I can just flip my watch and I can see my blood sugar readings directly here on my watch. It's been a little bit surprising to me, but it's actually been greatly beneficial for my diabetes management. I also really appreciate the InPen Dexcom integration. It's not real time, but it does allow me a really, really detailed reporting where I have both my blood sugar numbers and my insulin shots side by side. And again, something that really have helped me take my diabetes management to a whole nother level. But this is not a hard no. This is not me saying I will never try the Eversense E3. It's me saying just not right now. So before we finish up this now rather long video, I did ask Paul if there's anything else that he thought that we should know. So let's see what he had to say.
This is what the scar looks like after about 2 weeks. And I hope I've answered some of the most important questions about using the Eversense E3 CGM system. And if you have any questions at all, feel free to hit me up on social media. Just look for me on Type 1 Outdoors, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, website, whatever. I also have a YouTube channel called Type 1 Outdoors, and Crystal will leave a link for that. But anyway, feel free to hit me up with any additional questions that you may have. Okay, see you guys. Happy trails.
Thank you so much for watching this video on the Eversense E3 CGM. So what do you think? Will you try it? If you like this video, please click that like button and leave me a comment. If you're an Eversense fan, did I forget anything? Anything you want to add? And if you're not a fan, why not? Let me know. I know I'm not the only one who's curious about other people's experience. If you'd like to see more from me, remember to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. That is that little bell. And that way you'll be informed whenever I post new content. Thank you so much for watching.